It's the trail we have to take in order to get there. It's a long trail. Goes through three or four major cities on the outskirts. There's John, Kai. Hey guys, I'm on my trip. Dave couldn't make it, so my brother John came with me instead. I'll show you John. There's John. Anyway, I don't want to use up too much of the camera battery, so. Nope, it's weak. I just wanted to show you this section we found along the river. A bunch of kids, probably. But they did a pretty good job. You can see here they built a bench. The trees. Built some more benches. Logs. Brought down some grills, I guess. And they have their fire pit. I just thought it was pretty cool. A bunch of kids, I think, probably did it. I'll show you the river real quick. This river runs for miles and miles and miles and miles and miles. I consider myself lucky, I guess. I live close by. I'm only about 20 minutes from home. So it's not too bad. But, I don't know if you can see it or not. There's an island over here. And that's where I'm heading. Never been there before, so hopefully it's nice. So, like I said, I'm gonna try and consume battery life. So, catch you later. One of those streams runs into the Grand. Sounds like we got something moving around. Could have just been me. Oh, this guy. Waiting for me. Alright, there you go. It's just beautiful here. Absolutely gorgeous. Now we gotta go catch up with John. He's down the trail. This water is absolutely freezing. It is so cold and refreshing. It's awesome. It's awesome. It all runs out into the Grand River. John, Kai.
for this. All this plant life acts like a natural filter.
You can see that or not.
It's better than bottled water, I swear to God. It's like you just got it out of your refrigerator. It's absolutely fantastic.
There, John's calling me. I'll talk to you later.
I'm gonna call this quick down.
What?
If we had gone on that first island,
yeah,
we could have got across to that side. Look, there's no current barely.
I bet you the current's still pretty strong over there.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm tired.
Alright. Brother John is tired.
There's Brother Dave. As you can see, he's more than halfway across. This goes quite far. There's Kai, of course, has to follow along everywhere. He's still gonna try to go across. I think he's nuts, considering he left. Yeah, everything over here. Not very bright. Oh, here he comes. I think he can make it. But then he has to walk all through there, right through to this first island, and then to the second island where he wants to camp out there. It's quite far, but that's what he wants to do. Told ya, think you can make it.
Might be able to make it up there. The rock face, or the rock sticking out.
We'll have to see.
Hey guys, we didn't make it onto the island. The current was just too strong. Didn't want to risk it. Some things I forgot at home, so on and so forth. And it wasn't a failed day completely. It was a good hike. It's beautiful out here. I'll show you some of what I'm looking at. Absolutely gorgeous out here. So anyway, we found this campsite that someone else got set up. Probably kids came out here, have fires in the woods, and we're just gonna start a small fire in their pit. And dry things out, get the little dinghy put away, so on and so forth. Give Kai some time to rest. He's poor pup's pretty tired from all the swimming he was doing. aren't you, buddy? Kai? Are you tired, buddy? Huh? You tired? Yeah, you got really tired. At one point, he actually started to cling on to us because he couldn't swim no more. He was so tired. The current's just crazy. But, so we're gonna use this campsite and just get a small fire going just for an hour or so. Time to rest and dry out our stuff. All John's stuff is completely soaked.
Thanks, man.
He's not very happy about it. We gotta deflate the canoe and, she's almost completely deflated all by herself.
Nice.
Yeah, that's pretty nice. It's not a canoe, it's a little dinghy. So anyway, I'm gonna gather up some stuff here so we can, some kindling and whatnot, so we can get this fire going. I figure this stuff would be pretty good right here. It's pretty dry. This comes up when the river floods in the spring. All this comes up and gets all stuck in the roots. That's why the bank is all decayed, because the river floods and you see it. Oops, I'm slipping here. And it comes all the way up here and all the way up. It comes up pretty high during the springtime, so it's dangerous to be down here. So it's kind of low right now. Anyway, I'm gonna get this fire going and I'll catch you later. Hiking back to the car. Four trails. I don't know what it is they're doing over here. It's owned by the county. He's doing either. Oh well. I'll be back at the car in about 5 minutes. Farmer's fence. Gotta cut through here in order to get back to the trail where the car's parked. Uh-oh.
What?
That's a no-no.
What?
So, about 100 meters from the car, and my brother John remembers that he had dropped the keys back at that campsite that we found, and he just remembered now that he forgot to pick them back up. He got busy doing other things. So, I'm here in this farmer's field. I got both the packs, and he's hiking back. He's hiking back. Get the keys while I stay here with the dog and both packs. It'd be a lot quicker for him. I can't believe he did that.